It is a situational question, and in this question I want to check your understanding of communication channel. You see, communication channel is an important aspect of communication requirement analysis because it helps us to identify the complexity of communication and how many, you know, number of communications we have, either in terms of one to many or one to one or many to many. So these are the interactions among multiple stakeholders. So in this regard, we want to see which option is actually aligned with communication channel. Option number A says communication channel helps to identify stakeholders. It's wrong, because it has nothing to do with communication channel. Option A is all about identify stakeholder process, which is part of initiation process group. So it is not the right option for communication channel. Then option number B says addition of a single resource impacts number of communication channel. Yes. You see, even in an exam, you will find a lot of questions will say that previously you had 10 resources, now you have 5 more resources. Either they are asking you how many new channels created, what is the new number of communication channel, or what will be the difference from 10 resources to 15 resources. So you need to be very careful, and you need to use the communication channel formula, which is N into N minus 1 divided by 2. So in this context, option number B is the right answer for this, because it talks about the impact because of adding any resource in communication channels. Then let's see why option number C and D are wrong. Option number C says it helps to decide which communication format is needed. You know, when you talk about communication format, communication technology is the main area, because whenever I want to see how many people in a project, how early they need information, which type of environment you are working, you know, how many number of regions we are operating. So this is the part of communication technology. So this is not the right option for communication channel. Then we have option number D, and it says, you know, it helps to define communication model. See, communication model is all about how communication is happening in the project. You can say it's a communication process, that how sender is sending the information and how receiver is receiving the information, and if it is a complex situation, how you are encoding and decoding the overall communication. But here we are not talking about communication model. Our target was to understand the communication channel. So the answer for this question is option number B. Thank you. Those who answered correctly through knowledge, congratulations. For others, I hope it helped.